After 15 months in the Soviet Union, Oswald had grown disaffected with life in Russia, and his wish to become a citizen of the USSR had soured. By February 1961, he began communicating with the American embassy, hoping to receive their help in returning to the United States. But this would be a long and involved process, and he was told to go back to his life and his job and wait for news. On March 17, 1961, Oswald attended a trade union dance in Minsk, where he met a beautiful 19-year-old pharmacology student named Marina. He courted her aggressively, and a month later, they were wed. By the 1st of December, Lee's frustration over the Soviets' failure to award him an exit visa led him to send a letter to the American embassy, asking them to lie for him and claim he was being held against his will by the Soviet authorities. Of course, the American authorities refused. A few days after writing to the American embassy, Lee and Marina sent this Christmas card to Lee's mother, Marguerite, in Fort Worth, Texas. Less than a week later, December 11, 1961, Oswald was fired by the radio and television factory in Minsk, citing careless and unsatisfactory work and a negative attitude and demeanor as reasons for letting him go. Almost miraculously, 2 weeks later, on Christmas Day, the Oswalds were granted passports and exit visas, and within a few short months, they were on their way to Texas. On December 13, 1963, Congress passed Senate Joint Resolution 137, authorizing the commission to subpoena witnesses and obtain evidence concerning any matter relating to the investigation. 2 months after the publication of the Warren Commission report, the commission published 26 volumes of supporting documents that include the testimony and depositions of 552 witnesses and more than 3,100 pieces of evidence. Volumes 1 through 5 are hearings conducted by the commission members in Washington, D.C. Volumes 6 through 15 are hearings conducted by staff attorneys on location in Dallas, New Orleans, and other locations. Volume 15 also contains an index to names and exhibits. Volumes 16 through 26 contain photograph commission exhibits, plus other exhibits organized by name. Commission Exhibit 186, along with other important exhibits such as the Carcano rifle used to kill the president, caliber revolver used to kill police officer J.D. Tippit, Oswald Marine Corps rifle scorebook, are also referenced in Volume 16. This Christmas card, like most pieces of evidence that were either letters or photographs, was laminated and bears a sticker on the back identifying it as an exhibit from the Warren Commission. The commission then transferred its records to the National Archives to be permanently preserved, unless they were returned to their previous owners, in this case, Oswald's wife, brother, and mother. The records of the Warren Commission comprise Record Group 272, records of the President's Commission on the Assassination of President Kennedy. This group contains about 363 cubic feet of records and related materials. Dr. John Kingsley Latimer was a urologist who did extensive research on the Lincoln and Kennedy assassinations, becoming the first medical specialist not affiliated with the United States government to examine the medical evidence related to the John F. Kennedy assassination. He also was an avid JFK assassination collector who purchased a few of Oswald's letters from the well-known autograph dealer Charles Hamilton. Dr. Latimer ultimately decided to approach Marguerite Oswald directly to ensure obtaining all available material in a more cost-efficient manner. There are over 20 letters from Miss Oswald to Dr. Latimer, most discussing details of the sale of her son's items, including prices. They date from March 12, 1969 to February 6, 1973. Marguerite was a tough bargainer and yielded little in negotiations.
Three letters I wish to sell under the same arrangement as before are Commission Exhibit 186, 196, and 193. These are offered together only as a quick sale to you as a private buyer. please understand that by selling direct, I do benefit by immediate cash, but I lose out on the publicity, of which I also feel is important. My price remains the same as quoted to you. There are not many left, so we'll hold on to these if I cannot get my present asking price.
After Dr. Latimer passed away on May 10, 2007, his wife and three children put up his John F. Kennedy assassination collection for auction at Heritage Auction Galleries. The manuscript's auction took place on October the 17th and 18th of 2008, which included nearly three dozen JFK assassination lots, including the inscribed and signed Christmas card, Warren Commission Exhibit 186, which sold for, along with the addition of the buyer's premium, $6,572.20. The front of the Russian Christmas card bears an embossed color image of pine branches and pine cones surrounding a clock that strikes 12 o'clock, and a holiday greeting in Russian characters, meaning in English, Happy New Year. The blank interior contains the following inscription by Oswald: Merry Christmas, Dear Mother, From Us Both, Lee. It is also signed by Marina Oswald in Russian characters. The card measures roughly 8 by 5.5 inches. It is laminated in flexible plastic by the Warren Commission, and it was sent from Minsk in early December 1961. Although the card bears no date, we know this because of the envelope that accompanied it in Volume 16 of the hearings before the President's Commission on the Assassination. It contains the month and year it was sent. This particular item is excessively rare because Oswald's signed memorabilia are hard to come by, due to the fact that Oswald was only 24 years old when he died, and most of the Warren Commission exhibits are housed in the National Archives, with the exception of a few on the private market. The difference between this item compared to all other Oswald signed memorabilia is that it is signed by both Oswald and his wife, especially of such a personal nature, are simply non-existent with no records of any similar item in the market or even at auction. In addition, there are only two other Oswald signed holiday greeting cards on record, both of which are only inscribed by Oswald. The first was Warren Commission Exhibit 310, a Russian Christmas card inscribed by Oswald to his brother Robert. This exhibit is believed to have been returned to Oswald's brother, but there is no evidence showing that it has been put up for sale. The second was an Easter card inscribed by Oswald to his brother. This item sold at Nate D. Sanders Auction House on June 23, 2010 for a hammer price of $6,727. Although the Christmas card is laminated in a very light, totally flexible acetate, it is in overall fine condition. Lamination was a popular preservation method adopted by many institutions handling large collections of archival materials. First introduced in the 1930s, lamination quickly became the primary choice for repairing and strengthening papers on a large scale. Now, however, it is recognized that the materials used in lamination may degrade, damaging the very objects the process was intended to preserve. Because there have been no signs of damage or deterioration based on condition reports provided by the Smithsonian Institute, since it was laminated nearly 50 years ago, this item will almost certainly remain in stable state. Based on these observations, this variant lamination has uniquely preserved this item for over half a century.